In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Holy Spirit, please help me to do the preaching, and please make all my words your words, so that they can go and touch and change the lives whoever are listening. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Please help me to do the preaching. Amen. Holy Spirit, please inspire everybody who is watching this video, and make them to put it on the WhatsApp or on the Facebook or Instagram, or please inspire them to make it viral, so that many people gets the advantage of becoming holy and enjoying a good life on the earth. And please go ahead and get all the works done, whoever is helping in the proclamation work. Amen. Today is 17th of November 2020. Yesterday we were looking about Matthew 9 from verse 1, and I will read it. And Jesus entered into a ship and passed over and came into his own town, that is Nazareth. And behold, them they brought to him a man sick of the paralysis, lying on a bed. And Jesus, seeing in their faith, said unto the sick of the paralysis, Son, be of good cheer, your sins be forgiven. So what happens here? This people from the hometown of Jesus is bringing this paralyzed man on the bed. We saw it yesterday. We nicely understood what can happen into the in our day-to-day life, and why the people around us are falling sick. So it is very alarming nowadays, because too many sicknesses are come, and too many people are sick in our own society. Earlier in the olden days, like a couple of days back, 50 or 100 years back, this may not be the problem. So we have to be very careful why this is happening now, because the world has become too bad, very bad now. As you know, the media is come, and so the arms and ammunitions are available very easily, can be transported by the fast ships and all other things, and too many problems are there in the world. That is why the world is got become very bad. And by looking at this, we can see that Jesus is coming soon. There is no doubt in that, because if the world carries like this, a bad world with all the laws are made legal, all the laws which are opposite to the Bible, completely against the Bible are made legal, that means there is no much future left for this world, for this generation to survive. Because you see how even the faith is operating. Even Catholics, where they are gone, they are only depending on Mother Mary and saints, because God is not listening or hearing their prayers. That is what they are complaining. But God is always there, faithful to his words. So many promises are there. Go and just type in the Google, God, hear my prayer. Something like this you type, or prayer. Just type on the prayer, Google Bible verses. So hundreds of Bible verses will come, that how to pray, when to pray, whom to pray, and how God is listening to the prayers. That I don't have to tell you. Go on the Google and type prayers, and God is directly telling, speaking to you, Jesus, or God, even in the Old Testament, how is listening to the prayers. So you cannot blame God. You cannot just brush up and say, or you just cannot say in ignorance, that God is not listening to your prayers. This is the talk of foolish people. We are not animals to talk like this. We are human beings. We have a brain, and you have the evil spirit. Even I had it earlier, but now I got come into the changed, converted, and come into the faith that is called holiness. This to become holy is very important. You have to born again. Jesus said, If you want to come into the kingdom of God, verily, verily, I say to you, you cannot enter into the kingdom of God unless you are born again. Born again means what? You have to get rid of this evil spirit and allow the Holy Spirit to come inside you. This is called born again. But many people have put this name for this sect, born again believers. So don't get confused with my words. These words, if I use converted, born again, or believer, don't take these words as some other sect. No, these are the words from the Bible. Jesus has said, you must born again. Means what? You have to get rid of this evil spirit from you. And you must live with the Holy Spirit. You must live a holy life on the earth to take advantage of all the good things promised by God in the Bible. We Catholics are lacking all that because God is not hearing. We are praying to saints and to Mother Mary, those who are already dead and gone. We are praying, asking dead people to intercede for us. We are saying nicely, we are telling others. No, we are not praying to Mother Mary. We are asking our Mother Mary to intercede for us. Mother Mary is dead and gone. Saints are dead and gone. How they can intercede? If you have little brain, at least use that brain and think by yourself. This I don't have to tell you. This is common sense. People who are dead and gone, how they can hear your prayers? I took that parable last time, many days back, last month I think, about the rich man and the Lazarus beggar who was sitting by the gate of this rich man. Abraham was telling this rich man in hell that on the earth they have everything. We have Bible. Nowadays Jesus has come because Jesus told this parable before his death. Now Jesus is died and gone, and he is filled us with the gift and with the blessings to do wonders and miracles and help everybody and to heal everybody. But we Catholics are gone to such a miserable situation that we Catholics are asking saints and Mother Mary to intercede for us. Catholics are worse than animals. God has blessed when God created Adam and Eve. God, first words of God is, I am blessing you. These are the first words of God. You are not animals. You are like God. Humans are created by the likeness and image of God. This is what we are. But we are come to such a situation that we are asking the dead people to intercede for us, and we are enjoying our bad life. This is the sorry state of the Catholics. Nobody want to live corruption or cheating or bad life, adultery, robbing, gossiping, spoiling other people's name, cheating, all this, nobody want to leave it. In fact, they want to run to Mother Mary and to the saints, asking them, dead people, asking with the dead people to intercede. This is the worst in humanity, I should say. Asking dead people, how the dead people is talking to you, I don't understand. Even I was doing it the same. Whenever I get a message every day in my group of WhatsApp, one person is putting the picture of the saint of the day, and there is a message, pray for us. Or if message was not there earlier, I used to write, please pray for me, please pray for us. I was writing that because my eyes of heaven, my spiritual eyes were not open that time. Even before 2.5 months, even I was doing this blunder. I am not only blaming you. Even I did this blunder, asking the saints and Mother Mary to please pray for me and pray for my family. I don't know how a dead people can hear my voice from the earth. They are not God. Only God can hear this. God is same yesterday, today and forever. God created this earth from nothing. So please be careful. Don't waste your time. And don't. These are the works of the devil to keep you on the roundabout. whoever is telling you do the devotion of Mother Mary, pray the rosaries and you will get so many things, and do the novenas of so many novenas each week of Saint Anthony or Saint Francis Xavier or Saint Padre Jose Vaz or Blessed Father Agnel. You will not get anything. Only God can give you. The person is feeling sorry for the sins and confessing to God and promising to God that I will never sin again. And that time the miracle happens. And you all are saying Mother Mary has blessed me, and you are telling 100 people, and other 100 people are running after Mother Mary. You are saying this saint has healed me. You are telling my saint has healed me, given me a child. I was childless for 10 years. Now this saint has given me the child. And you are telling everybody, and everybody is running after this saint to get children for them. This is the sorry state of us Catholics. It is nowhere mentioned in the Bible. Saints will give you children, Mother Mary will give you children, or they can give you anything. Not even a cup of tea they can give you. This is the sad state of every Catholic. When you are into sin, God is not, God cannot, your prayers are not reaching. Forget about God cannot. You are blocking your own prayers. Your family is under the bondage of your action, and all the reaction the family have to blame. Your children and the newborn and your generation yet to come, they are suffering because of you. You have suffered because of your parents. And this chain is going on and on and on. And to break this chain, Jesus had come, because these Jews also were also doing the same thing. They made their own more than 600 laws on the top of these 10 commandments. So to break this, Jesus had come. And now when Jesus comes for the second time, you all will perish. Whoever is praying or interceding, you are saying nicely, you are not praying. But you are saying you are doing the adoration, or you are doing this novena, or you are doing this... what you call, okay, whatever, you are doing something or the other for the saints and Mother Mary who are already dead and gone. And you are doing what the Bible, the Word of God, is not teaching you. Our job is only to give them respect, and if possible, to become like them, take the example, tell the children that these are the examples. Now living examples were also there in front of us. So give your children all the examples. There is nothing wrong in that. It is very good, because they are holy people. They are not God to pray or ask them to intercede for them. Jesus directly said, you pray to my Father in my name, and he will do whatever you ask for. But I told you, every time I'm telling you, without sin means in holiness you have to pray. Otherwise your prayers are blocked by your own self, and prayers are not reaching anywhere. And you don't get any good unless and until you personally becomes holy. Even if your children are praying for you because they are holy, you can ask them to pray for you. But only you will be convicted of your sins, and you have to leave the sins, and you have to stop the sins, and you have to become holy. Anyhow, you have to become holy. Maybe anybody will pray for you. At the end of the day, you have to become holy. Nobody can take you into heaven, and nobody can force you and put you into hell. And on the earth, you are spoiling your own life, because you are least bothered about the holiness. So this man, this is a bad man, okay? Because see what Jesus is saying. Son, be of good courage. Your sins be forgiven. Means God, what is saying, what Jesus is saying to this man? Don't be afraid. Because what happens, you know you have sinned, And this consequence of what you are going through or what you are bearing now, what you are suffering now, you know very well that it is the consequence of your sins. Of your own sins, you are having this sickness, you know it very well. Or whatever problem is there, it is happening because of your own sins. Even I had gone through many of the things because of my own sins. So everybody is going through the bad things and difficult times because of our own sins. And this man was also very much aware. And by looking at his face, Jesus might have thought. That is why Jesus said this first word, "Son," he said. Jesus was comforting him. Be of good courage. Means don't get afraid. Don't worry. Everything will be fine. If you have sinned, no problem. Jesus is talking like this. See, son, be of good cheer or courage. Your sins be forgiven. Means what? To get the healing, I am telling you always, first of all, you have to be sinless. Anyhow, by hook or by crook, you run to Mother Mary or to saints, they cannot heal you. Unless and until you repent of your sins, you promise to God that you will not sin again, and you will love everybody, you will forgive everybody, that time the miracle is happening. Not because of saints and Mother Mary. They cannot do anything. They are dead. So better be careful. Don't waste your time. Because you don't know, praying to Mother Mary or asking them to intercede, you will die immediately or on the way before getting healed. Even the miracle might not come because might be your heart condition is very bad. You don't want to forgive at all. At that time, you will die with your sickness. Now, because you are gone to hell, and that is hell. You die in sickness means hell. And now, because after you go to hell, like that rich man and the Lazarus parable, you cannot curse Mother Mary from there or saints from there. You cannot curse them that I was praying to them and I don't know that I was getting fooled in the world, that if we ask them to intercede, things will happen. But when you go to hell, you realize that all who were praying to Mother Mary or asking them to intercede and asking saints to intercede, all are gone to hell. After that, cursing Mother Mary and saints, there is no use because they are already into hell because of their holy life. You have not made your life as per the Bible. Your condition or your state or your sickness or your troubles would have not been there in your life on the earth while you was living if you would have lived a holy life. For a holy person, there are no problems at all, and you don't have to pray anybody. You don't have to ask ask them or the dead people, the saints and Mother Mary, to intercede for you if you are holy. You don't need at all. You don't need at all to ask with anybody to intercede for you if you are holy. Because you are not holy, you are getting all these sicknesses. And then God is not hearing your prayers. Definitely, it is not reaching to God. It is not the problem of God. It is your own problem. And because God is not answering you, finally you are running to saints wherever they are. You are running to Mother Mary wherever you feel like. Or people are promising you your things will manifest over there. You run over there. So all things are happening in the world because you are not holy. You are into the sin. So you need some stepney. You need some jump start. And it is not working. You don't have Holy Spirit inside you. That is why nothing is working for you in your life. These are the direct words. Bible is very much clear. Bible is never telling you to run to anybody. Bible is saying, just become holy and ask to my Father, and my Father will do it for you in my name. Very simple. If sickness come, you don't also have to ask for God in the name of Jesus, your Heavenly Father, to heal your sickness. No, you don't even have to ask that also. God has made it very, Jesus has made it very, very simple. Just command the sickness in the name of Jesus and it will leave you. And add scripture at the back of it. You say after commanding the sickness to get out, you say Jesus has promised in the scripture that whatever a believer asks in his name or command in his name, he will get whatever he wish or whatever he say. Or second thing, you can command the sickness to get out and fall into the sea in the name of Jesus. Like Jesus said, you say to the mountain and the mountain will uproot and fall into the sea. So this mountain means your sickness. So this is scripture you have to add after the commanding, because this is the faith. This is called the faith. This faith, the scriptures you have to use to command the sickness to get out. Even you don't have to pray to God the Father in the name of Jesus. No, not required. I am praying this way only to make you aware that first of all, you need to stop immediately to praying to or asking Mother Mary and saints to intercede for you. That is why I have started in this fashion to pray to God the Father in the name of Jesus. So from beginning for 2.5 months, I am praying like this. Only to make you aware and to give you warning that you must pray like this and not you must ask to intercede the dead people for you. I told you they are already into heaven, and even after you go to hell, you cannot curse them, and it is useless because your prayers from hell, if you go to hell, your prayers from hell can never be answered. So better be careful. On the earth, when you are alive, you can choose how to live, in what fashion to live. It is in your own hands. Nobody can force you, even I cannot force you, but I beg you to change your life so that you can enjoy the life on the earth. Joy, joyful, enjoy. Enjoy the life through the 10 commandments. Keep the 10 commandments and the life will definitely be joyful. And your Holy Spirit will be there inside you. There is no doubt. Verse 3, and behold, a certain of the scribes said within themselves, this man blasphemeth. The scribes, the Pharisees were there, the teachers of the law. They was also there around because they wanted to catch Jesus. They wanted to find a fault in Jesus. So they were always running wherever Jesus was going. So they were against Jesus because they heard through the Old Testament scriptures that Jesus is the King of Kings. So the king was afraid that Jesus might take away or take over or overtake his kingship, and Jesus, the disciples of Jesus may make Jesus by fighting with the soldiers, because so many people started to believe because Jesus was doing miracles. So they were very much afraid. So they were behind Jesus to catch him if he speak any wrong, and to kill him and to trouble him immediately. So this was the Pharisees. They were talking at the back when Jesus said, your sins be forgiven. Your sins are forgiven. Because so far on the earth, before Jesus came, or even all the Old Testament, nobody have authority to forgive sins. And Jesus, for the first time when Jesus started a ministry, they could hear these words that your sins are forgiven, your faith has healed you, go and sin no more. So these were the words they used to hear, and they were upset that Jesus is blaspheming, means talking against the God, the creator of heaven and earth, the Yahweh. The Jews were calling him Yahweh. They were saying that Jesus is blaspheming because they want to kill Jesus in any way. So they started this backbiting, or started gossiping in the crowd. And behold, certain of the scribes said within themselves, this man blasphemeth. And Jesus, knowing their thoughts, said, wherefore think you evil in your hearts? Jesus came to know what they were thinking in their heart, because their words did not come out. But it is said here, this man blasphemeth. Within themselves, they said. Means they were not speaking, they were not gossiping actually, but they said in their mind. And Jesus know, because it is written in the scriptures that the eyes of God is 10 times brighter than the sun. Means we cannot hide, we cannot show our ignorance, we cannot lie to other people, we cannot just give false promises and false witnesses to others, because the eyes of God is 10 times brighter than the sun. Means what? Means even whatever a little thing you do, it is already written on the book of life in heaven. Only with one sun, with the normal sunlight in the good weather, even a small ant we can see, even a small needle is fallen down we can see, even a small piece of jewelry we can see with our own, with open eyes, without putting any glasses or without magnifying. Clearly we can see what is lost. We search even in the mud, we see, even in the sand we try to search, and we are able to find it, because the sun is very powerful. And imagine 10 times powerful. This is what God is comparing. Imagine if the sun is 10 times powerful, how much the sunlight will be. Means you know how much the God, the power of God is. If we think that in 10 years we will build a house, but God's wisdom is 10 times faster than us. If you become holy, God can give you a house just tomorrow when you wake up. This is the capacity. He is God. He is mighty. We will go to the prayers. We will continue tomorrow. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray. Please bless the family of Jesse.
Please bless the family of Jesse.
Please bless the family of Jesse.
Family of Bosco.
Family of Bosco.
Family of John Sequeira.
Family of John Sequeira.
Family of John.
Family of John.
Family of Aruna.
Family of Aruna.
Family of Mural.
Family of
Mural. Family of
Macley. Family of Macley.
Family of Zinia.
Family of Zinia.
Family of Connie.
Family of Connie.
And the family of the person on the YouTube.
And family of the.
And the family in the person on YouTube.
Make their dreams come true.
Make their dreams come true.
Keep them free from COVID-19.
From COVID-19.
Convict them of the bed.
Them off the bed.
Give them good jobs.
Give them good jobs.
Amen. Amen. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Bless Alex, Jamily, and Lorraine.
Bless Alex, Jamily, and Lorraine.
Make all their dreams come true.
Make all their dreams come true.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Bless Joaquin Stibero and family.
Bless Joaquin Stibero and family.
And make all their dreams come true.
Make their dreams come true.
Amen.
Amen.